Thank you, everyone, for being here this evening. I was in your seat last year, sitting and watching a presentation, and I was moved by that presentation. And I think, you know, bringing back the message to our health system went well. And so we'll get into that. So again, my name is David Walz. I'm from St. Cloud, Minnesota area. So we don't all speak like you betcha and you know. So, but I might be saying that once in a while. So here's our agenda for this evening. We're kind of go over an executive summary, introduction of the CentraCare Kidney Program, a little background of the staff-assisted home hemodialysis program, basic checklist of checklist and considerations for starting a staff-assisted home hemodialysis program, the dent setting setup, which we currently use, marketing considerations, census impact, clinical benefits, and patient success stories, why NxStage, and then we'll get into questions and answers. So first of all, executive summary. So following this presentation, you'll hopefully have a better understanding of how to start a staff-assisted home hemodialysis program, have more insight regarding the potential census impact of starting the same program, learn about the clinical benefits to patients receiving more frequent hemodialysis therapy at their nursing home, and to see the value of the NxStage system one. So introduction of the CentraCare Kidney Program. So we are located in central Minnesota, and here's St. Cloud. And so our service area kind of goes about this kind of right in central Minnesota area where we have 10 chronic dialysis units throughout central Minnesota. The health system, which I think is here, we're a magnet institution. We have a large hospital that's right on the Mississippi in St. Cloud, 489 beds. And here's some of the programs that we have within the health system and CentraCare Kidney Program highlighted there. So again, so we have 10 chronic dialysis units, and our acute program is at the St. Cloud Hospital. We have currently 5 stations. We're actually in the process of adding or moving to a new location in the hospital. We're going to have 10 stations to do acute dialysis. We do acute intermittent hemodialysis. We do peritoneal dialysis. We do CRRT, apheresis, and then we do aqueducts and aquapheresis as well. So background of the staff-assisted home hemodialysis program. So why we started? First of all, Minnesota, we have some bad weather in winters, can get cold. And so it was about 2 years ago when my medical director and I were standing in our facility, and we have stairs. We're on the second floor in our largest dialysis clinic. We have 24 stations plus 2 isolations, about 140 patients. We do nocturnal in that same facility where we have 20 patients coming in at night dialyzing. So we're about 7 days a week. And then our home program is out of that same facility where we have currently 62 peritoneal dialysis patients and close to 20 home hemodialysis patients, of which some are in the nursing home. So we were standing there and looking outside, and the Medivan pulls up with a dialysis patient, little old lady, and she gets out, no jacket, no hat, 30 below. And we looked at each other we said, you know, there's a better way. And so I sat in your seat last year, learned more about what's out there, what's our potential. And then the other reason why we really wanted to look at doing something different is capacity. So again, we have 24 stations. We have over 140 patients in our in-center hemodialysis clinic, so we're getting near capacity. And so at one point, we had 2 open stations in that facility, and that's the only one in St. Cloud. And we needed some more capacity so we can accept more patients that were in need of in-center dialysis. And so we thought, boy, if we could get some of the nursing home patients out of here, they're heavier. They use easy lifts and different mechanisms If we can get them to the nursing home or do them in the nursing home, it could be a win-win situation. And so that was the whole premise of why we really wanted to start this as well. So this is what we first did. So we got the nephrology group on board, and so we have a medical director over the whole entire program from a coordinating aspect of it, so Dr. Leiter. So he's the gentleman that started the dialysis program back in 1987, and so he's the medical director of the whole program. And then we have individual medical directors over individual facilities, and then the home program, we have a medical director. So we went to Dr. Corden and said, hey, what do you think about this idea? He loved the idea, and so he's the one that first started and really liked the idea and said, let's go forward. So then we went to the nursing home, and again, the health system owns the nursing home that we approached and said, are you guys interested? Because currently they had six of our nursing home patients coming to and from dialysis. And so it made a lot of sense with that patient population there already. They were excited. So they had a rehab facility, a physical therapy facility that they moved from the basement to the second floor closer to the residence. And so they said, hey, we've got space. So we went down and looked at it, and I'll show you a picture of it a little later. And we said, hey, you know what? This could really work. And so then they were on board, and we had discussions, how is this going to work contractually, et cetera. And we really wanted to get it going, and then we would figure out the details later, and we're still figuring that out. So then I went and filled out updated the CMS form, the 20 or the 3427, and notified Minnesota Department of Health. And so I called them up and I said, hey, this is what we're thinking. What do you guys think? And they're like, well, who else does it? Well, I gave them a list of who kind of does it. There wasn't a lot of people, nothing really in the Midwest. And so they're like, well, we're kind of looking at you guys to be the leaders here. And so I was a little nervous, but we wanted to do this hopefully the correct way. So then we asked, went to the residents that were coming to the dialysis three times a week, said, hey, what do you think about this? And five out of the six right away said, yep, sign me up. One was, I'm not sure about this. So we're like, all right, we'll start slow and we'll see how things go. So then we went to the nursing home, we identify the space, and we actually have five stations or den setting areas that we can dialyze five residents at the same time. Then we establish the water hookup, power, and the drains for the next day's machines, and all of that cost us under $3,000. So that was pretty impressive. And then we put up the TVs, and so in our chronic dialysis units, we have TVs for each of our dialysis patients, and one of our newest facilities that we just renovated, we had the poles in the old TVs because we put smart TVs in those, and so we had TVs, arms, and again, we didn't have any additional charge or cost to us. And then we had excess dialysis chairs that we brought over there, so minimal charge or expense to us to start this program. And then we decided, you know what, to do this right, we really wanted to provide the nursing staff. And so when we say nursing staff, it's the caregivers. And so we decided they would have to be either LPNs or certified hemodialysis technicians right from the get-go. So they couldn't be PCTs. And we didn't want to go down the RN route only because of the expense side. And so we did train the nurses in the nursing home about the dialysis. They round to the den setting every hour before they get hooked up, and then every hour as well. And then there's one nurse that's identified to be the liaison, and she attends our QAPI meetings with our team. So then we ordered the supplies and ordered the dialysis equipment, and we backfilled the caregivers where they were currently working out of our St. Cloud unit. And so that took a little bit of time. And then we started staff-assisted home hemodialysis in this new location. And so, again, our physicians, social workers, dietitians, nurse, go to the nursing home once a month for the QAPI meeting. And then the nursing home, they have an RN, and anybody else from their team want to come to that QAPI meeting, we invite them as well. And then outside of that, you know, we identified we needed a portable phone in that. So if someone's calling a physician, what have you, they would have a portable phone to make calls. Emergency preparedness, we are in conjunction with the nursing home, making sure that we're set up for fires and notification and tornado and all that kind of stuff. And we do the drills with them in conjunction with. And then we have a nice supply storage room. We put a scale in there, easy lifts, easy stands. We have a centrifuge and labs supplies, and the courier picks up our labs and brings them to the St. Cloud Hospital where we do our labs. Housekeeping is internal from the nursing home, so that really works well. Linens and laundry, again, the nursing home takes care of that for us. We have a refrigerators in there for, again, the centrifuge and lab items if need be. And then we got the keys and parking passes, make sure no one gets towed, and then medication storage as well. And so we don't keep a lot of medications down there. Most of the medications come with the residents down to the dialysis facility. So this is our sign outside of our location. So again, we wanted to make it look like it's their home, and it's home dialysis, especially to the surveyors when they came in and surveyed us. So this is our den setup. So this is one view of it, and here's another one. So we have five stations. We've got the chair, we've got the TV, NxStage with the peer flow, all right there. So, and the nice thing is, well, there's another room right to the right of this where we just obtained, and we're putting in the same items in that room, and we're opening up the wall in between the two so people can see through, but yet the chairs are still high enough that, you know, they'll have some privacy on this side versus the other side. So rather than five stations, we're going to actually have five stations. We're going to have 10 stations in this nursing home for growth and capacity. And we try to market this for the community and what's out there. And why this is important is two of the nursing homes that were living at a different nursing home, they've now recently transferred over to this nursing home because they heard about the benefits of not having to go outside now with winter nearing us. So initially, again, we had five NxStage system machines. We had five patients initially that started with this program because one was kind of, do I really want to do this? And it really went over really well. After a few months later, we had three more added to increase the census to eight. And since then, we had one when we did this slide, but now we have two that actually came to our facility from a different nursing home. And then one, interestingly enough, was in the short stay in rehab and liked it so much and felt better that now is a permanent resident of the nursing home and never went back home, which again, if she's feeling better, she still does her daily activities of living and getting out and seeing. She was nearing that decision anyways, and it just made it easier for her to make that decision to be a permanent resident. And so all our current patients right now are long-term nursing home patients. But the whole premise of doing this is to hopefully have some acute in rehab patients that are there for a short time, showing them how easy it is to do staff-assisted home hemodialysis to not only the patient but their family members, in hopes of them going home rather than back to in-center. So clinical benefits and patient success stories. Patients report feeling significantly better when receiving treatments more frequently in a nursing home rather than three times a week. And then soon after starting our staff-assisted home hemodialysis program, the following was observed in these residents or patients. They felt less fatigued, less likely to miss rehab sessions, improved appetite, more engaged in nursing home social activities, and required fewer medications. So we had one resident that started dialysis in center, and he was near signing off back in December of last year. And that's when we first started this program. And so he told our medical director, I'm going to sign off. I went and actually talked to this patient as well and said, we're going to start staff-assisted home hemodialysis. He lives in the nursing home. Are you willing to try it and give it a try? He started in December of last year. By spring, he was feeling so much better. He actually planted a garden. And then all summer long, he would go out to that garden. He actually tells me, he goes, I had a purpose again. And he would go out there and weed his garden as much as he could. He was in a wheelchair. He took steps for the first time in 3 years in rehab. And every time I go over there, he still thanks me. He goes, thank you so much. And his family thanks me. It's just a great thing to know that we're providing care to these residents, and I'm not sure longevity-wise how long it's going to last, but right now they're going to enjoy their time with their family and other residents, and so that's the benefit of that. So studies for more frequent hemodialysis therapy, again, more energy and vitality, improved appetite, improved survival, fewer medications, less stress on the heart, improved sleep quality, and so there's a lot of studies out there, and I know NxStage and others can get you studies if you would want to receive those. So more patient feedback and stories. So one of our residents, we do a start, stop, and continue as well for our residents. We do HCAP or ICH caps, and we do one other survey, press gainy. So, it's almost like survey fatigue at some point, but, these residents are the first ones to speak up and say, I love this place and the staff. Now that I can dialyze more frequently, I don't feel tired all the time. I feel so much better. I just come downstairs and get in my chair. And so literally these residents, if they're in a near wheelchair or walking or ambulatory, they'll actually come down to the dialysis clinic or dialysis den setting, do their dialysis, and they'll come down by themselves, just like they're going to the barber shop or to the dining hall, and then after dialysis they go back to their room or activity or wherever they're going. So my quality of life is better. I feel better dialyzing 5 days a week. No transportation to and from dialysis unit. Time as well as potential cost savings for these patients. So in Minnesota, the cost of transportation goes back to the patients or the residents. And so one resident was paying $1,500, $1,500 a month on transportation to and from. And we're only about 5 miles from the nursing home to our outpatient facility. And so he thanks me as well for that savings on to him. So why NxStage, you might ask? And so What we found is it is simple to use. Technology is simple. We can train staff easily and effectively. We can train our patients to use this system, and it works really well. And so flexibility to perform treatments in an individual treatment setting, and just individual treatment manner is a positive, and our nephrologists really like that. They can adjust what's needed for the dose to make sure that KTRV is delivered. The opportunity to transition to HHD for short-term rehab patients. So that is one of the things, again, we're striving to push is to get some of the rehab patients back to their home. Flexibility to utilize dialysate bags or peer flow. And so currently, we're not using the peer flow on multiple patients. We're doing it the first five patients. The next five patients in this setting, we're utilizing the bags. Minimal plumbing and electrical wiring changes required. So Again, we have water hookups, spigots. There's no big RO. Wiring was minimal as well, and again, it wasn't a lot of costs incurred in order to do this. Smaller treatment space needed. So if you're doing it bedside, which we still have that capability, and we may still do that in senior housing. So if we did have a resident that was living in there, we would actually go to that resident's home to do their dialysis. And then customer service and swap process. And so our biomeds really like this feature. So if anything goes wrong, which knock on wood, I don't even know if we've sent the machine back in the last 2 years for any reason. But it's an easy process. If something goes wrong, they have another machine there and we just swap it out. So NxStage is very easy and great to work with. So important considerations. Despite the health benefits that more frequent hemodialysis or home hemodialysis may provide to those with chronic kidney disease, this form of therapy is not for everyone. The reported benefits of home hemodialysis may not be experienced by all the patients. And the NxStage System 1 is a prescribed device, and like all medical devices, involves some risk, and these risks associated with hemodialysis treatments in any environment includes, but are not limited to high blood pressure, fluid overload, low blood pressure, heart-related issues, vascular access complications. The medical devices used in hemodialysis therapies may add additional risks, including air entering the bloodstream and blood loss due to clotting and accidental disconnection of the blood tubing set. We haven't experienced any of these, but they're just considerations that you should be aware of. When vascular access is exposed to more frequent use, infection of the site and other access-related complications may also be a potential risk. We've seen less hospitalizations to this date than we did prior to starting in the nursing home. So in essence, the nursing home patients were going to the hospital more frequent than now. We haven't had a hospitalization in any of our nursing home patients yet since we started, which is, again, cost-saving for the health system, and it's better for the patient. Patients should consult with their doctor to understand the risk and responsibility of the home and more frequent hemodialysis used in the NxStage System 1. And patients and providers are encouraged to contact their state regulators to discuss state-specific regulations that may impact dialysis in the skilled nursing facility setting. All right, well, thank you.